In this video, we'll take a look at how to animate titles in Final Cut Pro without the need for any plugins or keyframes. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Today, we're going to take a look at one of the most overlooked but extremely versatile built-in titles that comes with Final Cut Pro, the custom title. Let's jump into Final Cut Pro and take a look at what we can do with it. If you open the Titles and Generators browser, in the Build-In Out category, you'll see a custom title. Let's add it to our timeline and see what we can do with it. When you first add it, it's just a plain, simple title with no animations or anything like that, so basically the same as a basic title. In the Text Inspector, you can enter your text, change the font, size, colors, and a bunch of other parameters to make it look exactly the way you want. Still very much the same as a basic title. But when you select the Titles Inspector tab, this is where the custom title stands out above the rest. You have all these parameters you can adjust for the in and out animations, and the best part of it all is you don't have to use any keyframes at all. First, let's make our title come in from the right side of the screen. Place your playhead at the start of your clip, just so you can see any adjustments, and head back up to the Video Inspector. To make the title come in from the right side, all you need to do is adjust the position X value until the text is completely off screen. Click the number beside the X position and drag up until your text is off screen. Now, if we play this back, by default, the title animates onto your screen one letter at a time. If you want your full title to come on at the same time, in the inspector, for unit size, select all. Now, if we play it back, the entire title slides onto your screen at the same time. You can apply each one of these animations one character at a time, one word at a time, one line at a time, or like we did before, the entire title at the same time. Let's set this for one line at a time. Next, if you want to speed up or slow down this animation, you can do so by using the duration slider. Dragging the slider left will speed up your animation, and dragging it to the right will slow it down. Let's drag the slider to the left a bit to speed it up. I'll set mine to around 30. You can also change the speed type of this animation from constant to ease in or out or both, or even accelerate or decelerate your animation into the viewer. For this example, let's select decelerate. Here's what we have so far. Let's customize this a little more. First, let's fade our title onto the screen as it comes in. For this, all you have to do is drag the opacity slider all the way down to zero. Your title now fades in at the same time and moves into your frame. We can also add some fake motion blur to make the animation smoother. Open the drop-down menu beside the In Blur slider, and since our title only moves on the X-axis, bring up the X-axis slider all the way up. If you want even more blur, after the slider is maxed all the way out, you can go even higher by clicking the number beside it and dragging up. Let's set this to about 100. Also, let's bring up the tracking slider to animate the character tracking into our title. Since we're animating our title one line at a time, the second line animation doesn't start until the line before it is finished. If you want it to start sooner, you can set that with a spread slider. So if we set this to 2, you can see the second line start to move onto your screen before the first line is in place. So now we have this cool in animation, all done without using a single keyframe. Next, let's animate out our title at the end. For the end animation, let's make the title move all the way towards the viewer until it's completely off screen. Open the drop-down menu beside the out position, select the number beside the Z-axis, and drag up until your title is completely off screen. Holding down the shift key while dragging lets you adjust the position in larger increments. For the unit size, let's select all, speed up the duration, set the speed type to accelerate, and add a little bit of blur to it. Here's our finished result, all done without using a single keyframe. And as far as keyframes go, just because you don't need to use keyframes, doesn't mean you shouldn't. If you look in the inspector, each one of these parameters has a keyframe button beside it to let you adjust these animations even more. Play around with it and see what cool effects you can come up with. Here's just a few examples I came up with. If you enjoyed this video, let me know by hitting the like button and sharing this video with someone else who might enjoy it. If you're new here, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos uploaded weekly, so please subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.